It is Monday, May 8th, 2017, and welcome to this episode of Code Evolution. So I've done a few videos now that cover how to set up unit tests inside of WebStorm and using Mocha with TypeScript. And one of the things that I wanted to feature and kind of show off here was a script that I wrote some time ago that allows me to organize my tests into individual files, and it will properly run and test them in a structure that looks like a folder structure, which is kind of nice, and it's very helpful to keep things clean. So you can do things in WebStorm where you basically tell it to run a folder and then, you know, kind of recurse through these. But the problem is that it doesn't build out the structure the way you might think. It doesn't create the resultant test report in a nice kind of hierarchical way. So what I'm going to show you here is, first of all, the configuration that I have to run these tests. All I'm doing is pointing to this test file called importtest.js. I also have a prerequisite where I use gulp to build the tests ahead of time, just to be sure that I'm not running a test that may be obsolete or hasn't been compiled yet. So next, I'm going to hit play here, and I'm going to show you the build. And then that's going to launch into the report for the tests. A couple things that this script that I have here, import test, does is it kind of reports out which tests it's importing and the folder structure that it's using. You'll also see if we kind of... You'll see over here that it creates the describe structure required. If you see here, it uses describe and then the directory name and then slash to identify what node in this collection of tests that you're in. So let's look at, for example, the time folder, which has clock time and date time. By using this import tests code, what I'm able to do is not have to think about writing out all this extra code. It just uses the folder structure and the file structure to define what these describe nodes are named. So then all I have to do is effectively mirror the file system in order to see which tests I want to include in the whole test report. So if we go here again to like time and then clock time, and you can see that I've got all these tests here, but I don't write out clock time as a describe within the file. I don't have to, because it's properly importing those. As you may have seen in my other videos, you can also run these tests, these TypeScript tests, directly from here, and you'll get the results you're looking for as well. So you can cherry pick which tests you want to run if you don't want to run the entire suite. This does take some more work because these individual tests need some massaging in order for them to work individually as well as part of the entire test harness. So that's pretty much it. I just wanted to introduce people to the possibility that you don't have to write a lot of code in order to deploy and include your tests. You can basically create a file, you can put your describe and your it statements inside the file, but don't have to worry about what tree or node it belongs to. It's just a nicer way to view the report. As always, please give the video a like if it helped you. Definitely click subscribe if you aren't already, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks.